There's your baby girl. 8 pounds, I'd say.
Does this mean she's about ready to come out? Because I got a shot at the title this time. And that's not just a gold cup. First place is real money.
Effacement 90%, dilation 2-3 centimeters. Cervix long and firm.
Sounds like my scores at the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic.
Fetal heart rate 110 decelerates to 90 during contractions.
What's all the mumbo jumbo, though?
Your body's not ready to deliver vaginally, but your baby's in distress, so we're gonna have to get her out of there.
She's contracting. Baby's decelerating 89.
We're gonna have to do a C-section, okay?
Wait, Jose! You ain't cutting on me! I've heard about you doctors who wanna cut women open so you can go on home and finish your dinner.
Marla, you know me better than that.
Ain't heaven. No C-section. I've seen them scars.
Honey.
They're butt ugly.
If it's a scar you're worried about, no problem. I'll put it below the bikini line. No judge will ever see it.
You ain't sticking a needle in my spine. And you ain't cutting me.
Childbirth is scary. Surgery is scary. But your baby's in danger if you don't have the C-section.
You mean she'll die?
I can't say for sure.
So she might be fine then, right?
You're playing Russian roulette with your baby's life if you don't have the C-section.
Can you make me have one?
I can't make you, but...
Then get the stuff,
Marla,
off of me.
Marla, where are you going?
You can't keep me here, right?
No, I can't, but...
Then I'm out of here till this kid is ready to pop.
Marla.
What are you gonna do?
Follow her to the parking lot, wrestle her to the ground, and pull the baby out with my bare hands. That's what I'd like to do.
The two of us together might be able to take her.
Yeah, don't tempt me.
This is the closest we've been to each other in days. What do you say I come over to your place tonight and get some of these spots I'm missing?
Well, I've got surgery for the next 36 hours.
Oh.
But hey. How about noon tomorrow? Your place.
It's summer, remember? No school. Can you give me a few dinner?
Then I'd have to leave.
Kids. Well, why don't I come to your place?
Well, then you'd have to leave.
You'd think that we would have worked this out by now.
We have been doing this for almost a year. Coy mistress. Had we but world enough in time, this coyness lady would no cry.
Quote Marvel and I'll follow you anywhere.
We need a romantic getaway. What's
that?
Your ORs are ready, doctors.
And so are we.
You want to go up, I want to be just like you.
You're not so bad yourself, man. You know, for an old fossil.
Pass fire out of your mouth.
Come on, what you got? What you got?
Oh, yeah, a fossil of steel. Like a fox. Nothing but net.
Oh, that's two.
That was sweet.
Net.
That was sweet.
Jerome, your mama called me. You were supposed to be in school, and you should get to work.
Man, summer school's just a waste of my time. Me and geometry don't mix, man.
Well, you got the angles on the court. Geometry's the same thing.
I mean, if it helped my game out, I'd be all over it.
Tell you what, you teach me that slammer jammer, I'll teach you all about Pythagorean theorem.
You got us a plan.
I had to close my gallery for the second time this month. I am sick of being sick.
That is the most common complaint I hear from my patients with chronic fatigue syndrome, that and tender lymph nodes and throat redness, low-grade fever, and, of course, fatigue.
Well, that's me to a T. God, I feel like such a hypochondriac.
Your symptoms are real, Joy.
I just wish there were a real treatment. I mean, we've tried beta blockers, gamma globulin, and Prozac, you know? I mean, I'm still wrung out.
There's nothing new in your blood work. Of course, you're still testing positive for Epstein-Barr virus exposure.
Practically everybody's been exposed to Epstein-Barr. Why do only some of us get sick?
It's hard to say. Genetic factors, environmental triggers, stress. Are you keeping that journal we talked about?
Yeah. Read it and weep. You'll find the biggest stressor in my life at the moment is my upcoming high school reunion. Kate June High, class of 94.
You grew up in Kate June? Philadelphia's playground. I always wanted to go there.
You know, my old family home on the shore is my new summer place.
What could be so stressful about going there? Sun, surf, sand?
Oh, and memories of losing my first boyfriend to the head cheerleader. I mean, seriously, the thought of being reunited with the relentlessly perky Sheila Benson when I feel like the one least likely to get up in the morning.
That might be enough to cause a relapse. She needs a chest x-ray and an IV rehydration. I think these fluids might make you feel better.
Okay. I have no idea. Why don't you go?
Where?
To the cottage. Yeah, I mean, it's just sitting there empty. I'm so not up for this trip. Really, be my guest.
Cape June? It's Milo? Well, la-di-da. I've lived in Philly my whole life, and I've never been to the Cape. And at $1,000 a night, I'm pretty sure I won't be going anytime soon.
Oh, a patient of mine offered me her summer house.
Most of my patients don't even have a winter house, barely a winter coat.
Oh, who am I kidding? I can't go. My schedule book has a little warning on it. No beach time allowed.
Hey, don't worry about it. I'll clear the decks for you.
Sure, Lou, be glad to cover emergencies for you while you're hobnobbing with the rich and famous.
All right, but only if you cover for me when I want to go to Atlantic City.
Oh, thanks, Delgado, but really, I can't do it. Katrina's on vacation. I mean, who's going to watch my kids?
Me. I live with them, remember?
You would do that?
I firmly believe someone in our house ought to have a love life, and I don't mean Jesse.
Bless you. Oh, thanks.
Still no prospects?
Well, there is one possibility.
Uh-huh, girl, dish.
He's sitting over there, but don't look.
I think he's cute.
I think he's married.
I think he's gay.
Yes, he's cute. No, he's not married. And yes, he's well-groomed and definitely in shape, but I'm hoping for metrosexual.
Mm-mm. What do you know about metro anything? Todd, you from the boonies.
I know good taste in clothing doesn't necessarily mean a man is attracted to men.
I'm with Kayla. The man's clean, not gay.
Look, Lana is never wrong on this score, okay?
Never.
Oh, I smell a challenge.
May the best gaydar win.
All right, Iverson's here, and Eric Snow's here. Who's got the 90-degree angle of the basket?
Iverson.
Excellent. And Snow's angle is?
Swish.
You have the attention span of a gnat.
Yeah, my mom said I was born bouncing off the walls. I drove her crazy till I was like 6, and then she put a ball in my hands and told me to go outside and play.
And you can play.
Hey, let me ask you something. You find yourself having trouble sitting still, paying attention in school?
It's so boring. And besides, it's not like I got skills with smarts anyways.
What are you talking about? Hey, Scottie Pippen shoots 50 shots and he makes 15 of them. What's his average?
30%?
If you can figure stats like that, you're not stupid.
You're just distracted. Sit down. Your mind's jumping all over the place.
All the time.
You know, I've known you a long time, Jerome, and you are a smart kid. Could just be your brain's wired differently than others. I mean, you could have ADHD. Attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Could have you talk to an educational therapist or even a psychiatrist. And if you do have ADHD, we could get you on some medicine for it.
What type of medicine are you talking about, man?
Most likely Ritalin or some other kind of stimulant.
Like I need to be more hyper.
Well, in kids with ADHD, it actually calms you down. It stimulates the part of the brain that helps you focus. Paradoxical. I know. Ooh. All right, guys, that's me. Gotta go.
Where's my damn doctor?
Nice to have you back, Marla.
It's about friggin' time.
100% efface, 7 centimeters dilated, passing amniotic fluid with meconium. Pulse 120 decelerates to 80 during contractions.
Okay, Marla, your baby's in big trouble. If we wait for you to have it, it could be hours and she might not make it, all right? I can get her out safe and sound in a matter of minutes with a simple C.
Call the OR, tell them to set up for an emergency C.
I told you already, it couldn't be.
Every second that baby stays in you, she's deprived of oxygen. She could end up brain damaged or she could have a cerebral palsy. She could die.
Turn this thing around.
Marla, I am begging you to let me do this surgery.
No!
Honey, I know you're scared, but I promise you won't feel a thing. We could do a spinal block, or we could put you under, and you just wake up with a healthy baby.
What if I don't wake up?
You're gonna be fine, Marla, I promise.
What if you're wrong? Ain't you ever been wrong?
Sure,
no way! I'm not letting you do it.
I got your x-rays back. Whereas last year, your chest was clear. Now I'm seeing involvement of the lymph system.
What causes that?
Sarcoidosis is a possibility, but your ACE levels are normal. I'm going to order a biopsy for confirmation.
A biopsy? So you're thinking cancer?
Your symptoms point to only one possible diagnosis. Hodgkin's lymphoma.
I can't believe it. So I have cancer.
Most patients survive Hodgkin's disease. The sooner that we start your treatment, the better the chances are of a cure.
You know, in an odd way, it's kind of a relief that I have cancer, you know. Because something's really wrong with me. All those years having conditions nobody understands, and now I have something everybody understands.
I hate you, Lou!
Save your breath for the push, Marla.
I'm gonna turn the head now. Fetal pulse ox, 80%, fetal heart rate 79, and decelerating.
Okay. Marla, I want you to use those muscles. Push. Tell the neonatologist to get in your stat. Get ready to aspirate and stimulate.
The baby's been asphyxiated, blue and flaccid. We'll need to suction her.
What do we got?
You're probably gonna need to tube her.
What's happening? What's wrong with my baby?
She's having trouble breathing, Marla.
Was she gonna be all right?
God, I hope so.
On Lifetime, Real Women.
Real lives, real people, real events.
One voice can make a difference.
It is empowering and inspirational.
I could feel the burning of this can't happen. Just keep plugging away.
These women have found their justice.
I just did what I had to do.
You'll see it. We can make a difference.
Now the radii players extend to all hexagonal vertices from 6 equilateral triangles to form 2 right triangles. Now using Pythagorean theorem, I find out 1/2 of the base of the triangle, multiply that number by 2, finding out that the area of the triangle is 75 times the square root of 3. And I conclude that my chances of making this shot, better yet, my probability is 98%.
Okay, not only can he make a shot from anywhere on the court, he can describe it in geometric terms and calculate the statistical probability.
I am speechless.
Actually, I can't do all that.
But he did a damn fine job of memorizing the speech that I wrote for him.
Want to guess the statistical probability you're going to go dateless tonight?
But honestly, he got a passing grade on his geometry quiz.
And I didn't forget my homework, and I didn't get kicked out of class for mouthing off.
Now you're talking major progress.
That stuff you gave me is really helping. It's like the man said, you a genius.
You said that about me?
I think my chances of seeing you tonight might have just gone up a little bit.
Sweaty bit.
Alone at last, huh?
No kids.
No patients?
No beepers.
No cell phone.
Just you and me, miles and miles of deserted beach.
You want to play a doctor? How about in the water?
No! No!
No, no, down.
Do you feel like we're being watched?
Nobody out here but the seagulls, huh?
What you doing?
Hey!
Hi! Where'd you come from?
Oh, yeah, that's a real nice house. Now, shouldn't you go on back there and play?
I want to play here.
Yeah, well, so do we.
Hey, there you are. I've been looking all over creation. Hi.
Hi.
I'm Suzanne.
Hi, Milo.
Hi.
Andy.
Hi.
Mikey.
Yeah, hey, Mikey, how you doing?
Hi, Mikey. Whoa. Mikey, you got some real good bruises happening there. We're doctors.
Doctors on vacation.
You sound awful cranky for someone on vacation.
Okay, Mikey, you know what? Don't worry about the bruises. If he's got one, he's got 50. Enjoy your stay at the Seavers place, okay?
Well, hey. How'd you know we were at the Seavers place?
It's a small town. Why don't she open her eyes?
She's very sick, Marla. Her kidneys are working, but she's not sucking, and none of her other reflexes are responding either.
Marla Skaggs?
Who wants to know?
Julius Jordan, Child Protective Services. Dr. Delgado?
Yeah, that's me.
We received a call from your hospital reporting that Ms. Skaggs endangered the life of her child by refusing to follow medical advice and obtain a cesarean section.
What the hell?
Marla, refusing to follow your doctor's advice isn't a crime.
When child abuse is reported, I respond. My job is to investigate whether Marla is a fit mother and whether she should be allowed to take the baby home.
They're gonna take my baby away from me? Do something, Lou!
You weren't even here. You don't know what happened.
We have an eyewitness.
Dr. Jordan. Hey, here's an idea. How about giving me the heads up the next time you go behind my back and have one of my patients investigated?
I did what I thought I was supposed to do. Called Child Protective Services when a parent endangers the life of a child.
You are first year. You got questions, you ask me. You don't just go off half-cocked.
You mean like keep a level head and a soft voice even when I'm upset?
Do as I say, not as I do, all right? You're out of line.
You've seen her baby. She could be mentally impaired or never be able to walk or feed herself.
What happened with Marla's baby is sickening. But Marla is my patient. It's my call, not yours.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, I have you here for 5 p.m. on Friday. Yeah, great. Okay, we'll see you then. Take care. Bye-bye.
Hello, guy. Love this tie.
Thanks, Lana. Mm-hmm. Nice scarf.
Oh, this old thing. How sweet of you to notice. Guy, honey, listen. I'm missing a patient file. I was wondering if it might have ended up here somewhere.
Yeah, I don't believe so. What's the patient's name?
What patient?
The patient whose file you're missing.
Oh, that patient. Jones. Quincy Jones.
Okay.
You, mind if I take a look? You know, Guy, it's always so important to, take a look.
Yeah, maybe I should check the farm room. Mm.
Gay.
Well, just to let you know, this is not my idea of a good time.
We're only going to stay long enough to get this memory book that I promised to get Joy.
Mm-hmm.
And if we happen to bump into Sheila Benson and she's gained 20 pounds since graduation, all the better, because it'll cheer up Joy.
It's the least we can do for our hostess. Okay, mister.
What?
Show me some of your moves.
Oh, you want to see some of my moves?
Yeah, you got any?
Do I have moves?
You have
moves? Is that what you're asking?
Yeah, I want to see it.
Yeah, watch this. Yeah. Yeah. Watch this one. Oh, no.
No, thanks, man.
Yeah, all right.
A little too much party juice. Hey, weren't we in whole room together?
No, I don't think so.
I got it. You were a cheerleader, right?
Hardly. The two who was a cheerleader, Sheila Benson. Is she here?
You don't know about Sheila? I hate to be the one to break it to you, but she was dead. Cancer. Bummer, huh? Welcome home, class of 94. I'm Mayor Arnold Sweeney, but you already know that. Half of you TP'd my house on senior night. No hard feelings. But when you go back to your cars tonight, you might find a little present from me on your antenna. How's that? Have a great time, everybody. Welcome back.
Guy, today is your lucky day.
What's up, Pete?
I scored 4 tickets to the Phillies-Mets game.
Oh, man.
4th row behind the dugout.
No way. And you're asking me?
Yeah. So what do we do with the other two? Got someone you want to take?
I'm in between squeezes right now.
So happens, I know a smoking brunette who might want to be set up.
Great. Wait, is the game Sunday?
Yeah.
I can't make it. I promised my boss I'd go to his kid's birthday. Rain check?
Sure. The brunette, right? Right.
Carrie Steele, 24, cancer. Tom Branson, 26, lymphoma. Sheila Benson, 28, Hodgkin's disease. That's 9 dead out of a class of 65.
Yeah, all from cancer.
This is very... Okay. Mr. Mayor? Andy Campbell?
Hi. Arnold Sweeney.
Milo Mort.
Hi.
Hi.
You folks aren't here for the reunion. I never forget a face.
We're doctors visiting from Philadelphia.
Huh. First time here? Have to take the carriage ride around the Cape. It's very romantic.
Mr. Mayor, one of my patients is from the class of 94, Joy Sievers.
Sure, Joy. How is she?
Actually, not well. She has Hodgkin's disease.
Very sorry to hear that.
But we couldn't help notice that several members of Joy's class have also died of cancer.
It's terrible, isn't it?
In a town the size of Cape June, it's actually a disturbing statistical anomaly.
I call it an unfortunate coincidence. So, how long are you docs in town?
A few days.
Too bad you have to leave so soon. Take care.
Breakfast on the beach, even better than breakfast in bed.
I wouldn't complain either way. You know, it's almost like he was hiding something.
Who?
Mayor Sweeney last night.
Well, the possibility of a cancer cluster in Cape June is clearly not something his honor is interested in discussing.
I don't suppose the Centers for Disease Control has been notified.
That would be the responsibility of the local public health commission.
Who serves at the pleasure of the mayor, I'm sure.
Help! Help! Help me, please! Help! Help me, please! Mikey! Can you hear me? Come on, Mikey! Everything's gonna be okay, Mikey!
Hold him right here. Set him down!
I couldn't get him to wake up, and then I noticed all these little specks all over his skin.
Hemorrhaging under the skin.
Pulse rate high. Lymph nodes swollen, he's burning up.
Liver and spleen are enlarged. Non-palpable petechia. Did Mikey complain of having a headache?
Yeah, last night. Why? What is it? What's wrong?
He may be bleeding internally.
We gotta get him to an ICU.
Our local hospital doesn't have a trauma unit.
I'll call Rittenhouse to tell them to send a medevac.
TV news journalist Joan London is 57.
We need the pan culture and fair ink's blood in urine.
Just send a stool sample for hemocult.
Chest x-ray?
Yeah, and a CBC with this. Okay, on my count, one, two, and.
Am I gonna lose him?
Mikey is stable for now.
It's leukemia, isn't it?
Has he been diagnosed?
No, but in the last 2 years, 15 kids from Cape June have come down with it.
If it's lymphocytic leukemia, that's a treatable disease. It's an 80% survival rate.
Yeah, statistics don't mean a lot if your kid's one of the 20% that doesn't make it. Two of those 15 have died.
Suzanne, I can assure you that Mikey is going to get the best of care here. Come on, sit down.
Thank God you were vacationing at Cape June.
There's something I don't understand. Why just stay there with so many people getting sick?
Well, where could we go? My parents, my sisters, Mikey's cousins, they watch him when I go to work. My job's at the hotel.
Aren't people getting worried with what's going on?
No one wants to talk about it. It's all very hush-hush. Look, those of us who live there year-round, us townies, our livelihood depends on tourism. If the tourists stay away, the town goes bust.
Not talking about it isn't going to make it go away.
If we talk about it, Cape June becomes Cape Cancer. Who'd vacation there?
Oh. You need a new car.
Excuse me. Whose car is still running and whose car is in the shop?
Yeah.
What time's our meeting with Child Protective Services?
Before lunch, and it's going to be a little touchy.
Touchy how? Touchy situation or touchy for me?
Both. Kayla was right to report this. According to hospital regulations, they're just cool with your jets. We'll take care of this.
My players.
Hey,
Dr. Delgado.
I am Dr. Delgado, you freak out. You're gonna hit me now too,
Look,
Donna?
I would slow down if I were you, okay? I will give you a chance to explain yourself before I hit you back, but she might not. So before you start round two, who the hell are you?
Joey Donegan. I coach basketball at Franklin High. Jerome LaPalme, he's one of my players. He's a great kid, terrific athlete. Been coming to practice all week singing the praises of Dr. Delgado. Life's so much better since Dr. Delgado came along. Then he goes and fails his preseason drug screening.
Exactly what drug did Jerome test positive for?
Some kind of stimulant, methyl something or other.
Methylphenidate is the generic term for Ritalin. I prescribed it to Jerome to help him do better in school. And it's working.
You're trying to help him in school?
Yes.
Oh, boy. They don't call me Coach Hothead for nothing.
Yeah, go figure.
I'm sorry. But you gotta understand, I love these kids. I don't want anything bad to happen to them.
All right, what if Jerome gets a note from Dr. Delgado explaining the necessity of this medication?
I'll give it a shot. But that methyl whatever, that's on the list of substances banned by the District Athletic Association. They're pretty hard-nosed about this sort of thing. Unlike me.
Try to focus on something positive. Happy times, like growing up in that beautiful beach house.
It was idyllic. You know, back then it wasn't a resort for millionaires. You know, it was just all ocean and farmland, and we'd play outside for hours. I still miss the open fields, you know? Except, of course, you know, when they were dusting the crops. But
dusting with what?
You know, I don't know. These foul-smelling green clouds would roll in over the fields, and you know, it made our lungs hurt. Do you think that's what caused this?
It could be a piece of the puzzle. Did it make you sick as a child?
No, not really. You know, I never missed one day of school until my senior year. I had mono when I was out for 6 weeks. You know, it seemed like everybody had mono back then. They called it the kissing disease. That's when Sheila Benson and I had our little falling out. See, because Sheila and my boyfriend Tom and I, we all had mono at the same time. You can imagine the implications, right?
They may be greater than you know. There are studies suggesting that young adults who get mono are at greater risk of getting Hodgkin's lymphoma. It's a small risk, but it's real.
So, are you saying Sheila and Tom are at risk for Hodgkin's as well?
Joy, about Sheila and Tom.
Oh, no, no, no. Don't even tell me. They were at the reunion together, weren't they? Oh, my God. I could tell from the look on your face. They were married, right? Oh, gross. Oh, whatever. You know, I can take it. Oh.
What is it?
Oh, I feel lightheaded.
Here, lie down.
Oh, God, you wouldn't think I'd care so much about Sheila and Tom 10 years later, right? Oh, my God, my heart's pounding.
Code blue in room 214, 5 cc's of lidocaine, stat.
What's wrong?
Your heart is having a reaction to the chemotherapy. Joy, 50 is 70 and falling. Heart's racing out of control. Got that lidocaine?
It's inaudible.
Lidocaine going in. We've got YQRS complexes and no P wave.